There was no filter with him.
Yeah, it was no filter.
He didn't think about whether, you know, the how this is going to come out or what the repercussions of. It's like, this is how he feels and this is how he's going to say.
Yeah, this is how he's going to let you know.
You know, and I got to say, you know, because I did get to film him a little bit.
Yes.
And out of the 1,000+ people that I've interviewed over the years, I've never had a situation where I just had to just press the record button and X would just be the star of the show. Completely.
Mm-hmm.
Completely. Just an absolute star from top to bottom.
Top to bottom.
Without trying to be. The cameras didn't have to be on. Like, you know, he was just DMX and that energy 24/7.
Yeah.
Drawn to the camera, you know, starting a bunch of films.
People called him DMX, but he always was just Earl the whole time. That's Earl, really. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, that's how Earl is. Earl, the one from Yonkers, if he rock with you, he rock with you. If he didn't, he didn't. You know what I'm saying? You know, if I, like, all he really cared about was his dog that he had. That was, like, his real best friend. You know what I'm saying? So all he really cared about was dogs. So when he was in Yonkers and stuff like that, he used to be by himself with dogs. So far as with people and stuff like that, he just never really had, like, too much of a trust as far as with people. He always trusts a dog because, you know, he know a dog unconditionally is going to always show him love no matter when he leave, when he come back, that dog going to be at the door. And that's what he appreciate that, you know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? He was all about unconditional love, not conditional love where it's like, okay, I rock with X because he lit right now, but you know what I'm saying? You know, he was aware of that, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And dogs don't do that.
Right, and right, because, I mean, these days people are getting tatted up from head to toe,
mm-hmm.
but he was one of the first rappers I'd ever seen to get a full back tattoo.
Yeah.
And it was of his dog.
And I was there for that, too. It took him, that was like 3-4 trips.
I bet. I mean, it was a three, huge tattoo. 3-4
trips to the Bronx. That was in St. Lawrence and St. Lawrence and Westchester. And he went in my man Uncle Ralph tattoo spot, which is around the corner from my hood where I'm from. And he was going there. He got the one. It was killing him. Came back, got the love. It was killing him. He was like, yo, that's it. That shit gonna say one love. I'm good with one love, dog. Then after that, he put the one love boomer.
Yeah.
So he came back. I think he just put the boom. Then came back and put the ER. Like, it was killing him, you know what I'm saying? But he sat there and he got that joint done. You know what I'm saying? Well, you find times. But you know, I was actually there when he got that tattoo on his back. Yeah, that joint killed him, but he got it.
Yeah, I mean, who do you know that tattoos their actual dog on their entire back?
Yeah.
With the dog's name.
Yeah. In big letters.
The entire back.
Yeah.
No one has done that since.
Yeah.
Or before.
Yeah. Yeah, for real.
Yeah, man. Such a unique talent, man. And such an epic loss. And like I said, we were days away from interviewing him.
Yeah. That interview would have been dope.
Yeah. Yeah. It really would. Because, you know, we really were gonna dig into his whole background, like his relationship with his mother, you know, and how he was even drawn to the dogs was because he was living in such an abusive home.
Mm-hmm.
He became homeless. At one point, the dogs really kind of became his friends.
Yeah, for real.
It's like a real thing.
Yeah, it's a real thing. It's a real, I'm telling you, he used to, he used to sleep on the roof and stuff like that, you know, you find out?
Yeah.
And sleep in peace because he knew that dog was right there. So, like those that knew he was up there or tried to creep up or just try to do whatever, that dog was up there and he never really had it.
Aha.
Yeah.
So it was like his protection, his bodyguard, it was his basically.
Protector. Yeah, it was his protector. You know what I'm saying? So he would sleep up there and he ain't got to worry about nobody coming through the door because the dog, the dog would make a noise and his dog is not really on it. Like, you know what I mean? You know, like he treated his dog like his homie, so he didn't just always chain him up and strap him. No. It was something. His dog would be run right around on the roof with him or be laying down next to him when they hear something, get up. And his dog going to get up and get to you first. You know what I'm saying? So.